We're here at GFA Gallery in Gainesville and at my show, Archive Memories Innocence. So this really stemmed from my family's move after 25 years in Florida to Colorado and all of the emotions, memories that were flowing back to me as we made that move. So a lot of the pieces deal with archiving those memories, and also the process was very cathartic for me. So in a lot of these, there are specific times and moments that were brought together to form a single piece or to touch on greater themes of family, childhood, and relationships.
The pair of drawings, Closed for Business and Open for Business, reflect feelings of loss and then acceptance and understanding surrounding life events. My attachment to my family felt like that of a child, innocent, rosy-eyed. And so I took the time to go through the family archive of pictures with my own mom, finding photographs that I connected with emotionally and whose composition would touch on greater moments felt by a wider range of people. The photographic quality places the viewer in the position of the mother capturing that intimate moment. So by placing the viewer in a specific position, I invite the viewer to interact with the drawing emotionally. The Woven series explores the fluctuation of memory. The disjointed and pieced together drawing represents how my childhood home sits in my mind. Sometimes I can remember every detail, and sometimes I can't remember where things were placed. And at other times, the house feels like a gesture. I don't even know if this memory can be trusted, and I can't return to this home any longer, so I feel the need to replicate it as I see it, torn apart and placed together by my own memory. For each piece in this series, I had to create two drawings. So in that way, I was really solidifying what I was thinking about as I was drawing, and then cut strips of each piece to piece together and to weave, so that parts of each drawing were overlapped by others, and it became sort of like a puzzle. Creating that puzzle-like structure reflected the variations of that memory that I tried to record. I chose books because there's a permanence surrounding them, and also because the tunnel structure created a three-dimensional space. In making the books, I hope to cathartically transfer my memories that might fade or have already done so in order to keep them as pristine as possible. They also work as an archive. I was able to intertwine a variety of moments into each book over a wide range of years by incorporating specific elements from certain times in life. As I continued to archive the memories, though, it became harder and harder for me to render parts of that memory that I know are there, but I couldn't quite make out enough to render fully. That's why I chose colored pencil, because a lot of times focusing on the color of an object brings back more specifics of that element. The two tunnel books made with pen, on the other hand, explore family relationships specifically during the move. So my parents and my siblings feel really distant, while parts of their personalities I know remain ingrained in like my own identity. The scale of the books reflect the familiarity of the disposable camera photo, which I know is familiar to a lot of the audience.
Hi, my name is Lauren Mann, and I am a fourth year drawing major at the University of Florida, and I'm originally from Clearwater, Florida. We're here today at the GFAA Gallery in Gainesville, Florida, at the show Intimate Interiors, Figures in Space.
This body of work strives to portray the beauty of the ordinary characteristics and experiences present in everyday life. In a time and space full of chaos and disappointment, I find it comforting to be able to stop and appreciate the innate beauty of the human figure going about simple and familiar tasks. These illustrated narratives reveal aspects of individuals' personalities and lives that add vibrancy to the common thoughts and experiences of the everyday. By primarily using color pencils as my medium, I add high levels of detail to my work and am able to highlight the little things that make these everyday tasks unique to each personality. Color pencils also allow for vibrant and colorful portraits, and through these pigments, I emphasize the energy and personality living within the sitter, as well as juxtapose these vivid colors with the more somber and uncomfortable feelings that some of these drawings convey. By inserting these small idiosyncrasies that require a careful examination of the image, I challenge the viewer to look deeper and find similarities between the feelings and moments conveyed through the works and the viewer's own lived experiences. Recently, my work has been primarily dealing with the topics of isolation and loneliness that I've been experiencing a lot within the past year. And in this piece that is entitled The Sun Came Up Today, I wanted to make a commentary on the current state of disarray in the world and the thought that I have that sometimes the only idea you can cling to is the fact that the sun came up today. Reading the news can be such a disheartening activity, and through this drawing, I strive to illustrate that there is always at least this to be thankful for each day. This drawing is entitled Ending the Year with a Bang, and I created this piece in order to illustrate the results of the feelings I was having at the time of being overwhelmed by stress and frustration that incited my decision to cut my hair. I believed this change would fix everything I was feeling, but it only made things worse. And this confusion and sadness I felt as the process became much more destructive than cathartic is represented through the expression on my face. The muted, cool tones of the sweatshirts that I chose allude to the despondency I was feeling, which contrasts with the busy and colorful patterns on the walls that signify the hectic and chaotic elements of life that were overwhelming me at the time. For these works, Valentine and Valentine Studies, I chose to include the studies in the show to be able to represent a bit of my process and show how I create first compositional sketches to be able to see the different poses that I can work with and be able to see how the poses are coming through and which emotions they are expressing to be able to pick the one that is the most effective for the larger work. So for the work Valentine, this drawing juxtaposes the saccharine aesthetics of Valentine's Day with the unpleasant feelings of loneliness and isolation one may experience when they find themselves alone instead of living out an idyllic romance. The pattern of hearts covering the figure's clothing evokes her desire to have a Valentine, but this longing for the ideal person is contrasted by the inclusion of Hogarth's The Tavern Scene above her head that symbolizes the perpetual downfall of a flawed humanity. The discarded tissues and chocolate wrappers, as well as the nearly empty bottle of wine, allude to the heartbreak and emptiness felt when one imagines others to be living out a perceived ideal that they may never achieve.